A man is wandering in the wood. He's misunderstood a sign and stands on a half-exposed, half-forgotten hill, just himself. He remarks out loud that the view looks like a desktop background. He's quite pleased with his comparison, a chuckler's reward. Walk on. B's fumble in the brambles reminds him of numbers tumbling down through his spreadsheets. He sees a BlackBerry crushed lying by the path and says, "Shame for someone's lost their phone, alas, again." Don't worry, there's no one around. Sounds of lorries passing on by are filtered by the pins and needles of the trees. He relishes the comfort like his premium leather chair. He likes the way wood looks. It's been grown. Its grooves and rings suggest how much it has grown in solid years. An odd thought pops into his head to knock and ask his desk, "You grew so much in this year," and it replies, "Did I? That seems rather peculiar. Oh yes, I remember now. That was the year of the rich rains and the generous sun. My late brothers had fallen and I needed to grow in their place." You see, it's cutthroat being a tree. The slowest race. You can be winning for years, then one day as your prize, you're chopped down, flown and cut into an expensive desk. It could be worse, mind. I have a friend who spends most of his time now as a few thousand toothpicks. The man is troubled and speaks forth. I once heard reincarnation is a tree, what happens to impatient people. It forced them into a life of waiting, making the best of their lot in life. His desk ponders. Rubbish. It's what you get when you've been living too slowly. You see how wasted it is, how straining outwards at a leisurely pace will kill you. You have to reach up and catch every morsel of light, spreading leaves like fingers to cast shadows on the floor, nabbing light, endless fight, or you starve. The man finds himself back at his car, sports convertible model, drives home, prepared for work, the day after tomorrow. Thank you.